Hello guys, welcome to the fifth episode of Achievement Speedrun. This time, well, I stopped right at the place we found up. First chest with the diamonds and things like that. And, well, we're going, this episode I think we should go back up to the surface and try to create another portal using our buckets, because we don't have enough diamonds for an actual pick. So we only have one, that's only enough for, well, just to get the achievement, I guess. And, well, I know diamond shovel and a diamond and a jukebox, I think. And for some reason it's really laggy. Might have to... It's... Well, I'm going to try to see if I can... Well, I can put the particles a bit less, but... Well, that's a bit... Oh yeah, I'll put it on, I don't know, balance or something. And, yeah. Yeah, it's still pretty laggy, but... Well, yeah. Oh, what the... That's really, well, lucky, you could say. I mean, we just found about two chests. Not even 10 squares from each other, that's a bit... strange, but okay. Anyways, yeah, we need to clear up some inventory space. I'm going to just start off by transforming this all into sticks, I guess. And yeah, then we have enough space to pick everything up, I think. Wait, also there's some more coal over here, and seeing as I, well, we have 5 coal in a stack, I think we should get a bit more of it before we go back up. So I'm just going to grab some more of it. Also, the iron, I will pick up the iron too. But after that gold and the iron, I think I will try to retrack one of the lava lakes we found in the previous episode. Then I can, well, go dig a shaft upwards, and I take... And then I can transport lava buckets up and down, and will at least create another portal up at the top. That's the, well, goal at least. And yeah, I know this is just such a good cave, but I feel like I will have to give this one up. Or, I mean, it's a good mineshaft, I mean, it has lots of stuff in it, but I will have to, well, yeah, just wait until next time we go mining, then we will probably go for, well, then we will probably just go for this cave once again. At least if we can find the shaft back, which we are going to build up, and the lag is a bit making me nervous right now. I hope it doesn't bother you too much, but, well, it bothers me a bit. Because I think it's about, I don't know, 10 frames per second or something? Oh god, even less. Even less. I don't really know why it is, but... Well... I don't actually think the max FPS would help anything, because then only the recording software becomes slower and, well... Yeah, there's not really a good way to solve this problem. And just guess I have some bad luck with timing, and there's, I know the computer is updating or something like that. Apart from that, I wouldn't have any explanation for it. Yeah, oh god. Well. As long as I don't really mess something up in-game and don't think I should redo it. Because, after all, this is not a let's play, this is just proof for my series to, well, prove that I am actually, well, how do you say it, I'm actually doing everything here on survival. And yeah, the speedrun itself will be legit. So, unfortunately, I don't... pay too much attention at the quality of the videos themselves. So, well, Yeah, I think I'm a bit lost actually. Yeah, it looks like it. So wait, this chest was right over there, I think. Yeah, that means I came from here because I saw it from here. And here's my staircase. Yeah, now I'm going back. I also came from here. At least that's what I think. Then here. And then this way. Oh yeah, this cave slash shaman shaft there, I remember this too. And we're back at the original cave, it seems. Yeah, where we found our first redstone and stuff like that. So, well, I think like that, oh wait, I'm going to grab the iron over there too. So you really need a lot of iron, like I said in the last episode. I mean, yeah, iron rails, you will need a whole lot of it. So that's, well, it's a good thing to just mine it already. Also, well, I think like, yeah, I should go up here, but yeah, I'm hesitating a bit about whether I should keep this water bucket or I change it for lava buckets, because there will be, probably there will be some water up at the surface. So, yeah, I think like I will just transport lava until I have like a reservoir, or which way your prince arms it in English, up at the top, which is, well, made out of 10 lava buckets. So we have 2 buckets of lava now, that's good. I feel like I should organize stuff like this. Oh yeah, also, I'm going to, okay, I got my crafting bench, good. Yeah, I'm going to make use of the repair function a lot, probably. Well, maybe you didn't know it, but if you use the repair function of a tool, which is basically putting them both into crafting grids to get a new item of it with stacked durability, you still also get more durability than you would, well, than just adding both durabilities on top of each other. You get, I think, about 10% more than you would normally get, I think. So that's why I will be using it, because it's a bit more efficient than just breaking your tools and using a new one. Yeah, I'm hearing lava and I'm a bit, well, afraid of, well, that I could be digging right into lava and then I probably will be dead. Even though it's unpeaceful, you don't have that much time to escape if you don't have armor. So yeah, I'm going to mine a bit ahead of me, and yeah, especially with this lag, or at least with slow frame rate, it's a bit like, even if there is lava, it will already flow halfway to me before I'm able to well, do anything, because of the low frame rate, I think. However, I could be mistaken, I don't know that much about the game mechanics. Oh, for a second I was mining stone with a sword. That wouldn't be a good idea. Okay, we're about 1/3, I think. Well, it differs a bit. If you're, for example, going up in an extreme hills biome, it could be that you have to dig 30 blocks more than you normally would. So, yeah. But I think now I'm in a, oh, I'm in a plains biome. Yeah, I remember a bit, yeah, from 2 episodes before we, yeah, it was a plains biome. I don't think it was that far from our desert biome where the NPC village was located. Yeah. I'm actually also a bit happy about the fact that, hey, wait. Oh, I was already, this is lit by me. That's a bit strange, but okay. I'm just going to keep the pattern in this shaft. And I can hear sheep, yeah. Yeah, I remember it 2 episodes ago. There were like all those sheep underground. Yeah. God. When I dig dirt, it's a bit too loud for me. I'm going to turn the volume down a bit here. And I think we should be about there 50. Oh, 40, never mind. Anyways, it will still take quite a while, I think, until, I'm actually all the way up, until I have transported all the lava, because if you look at now, and, oh, okay, I was, but, oh yeah, oh god, I have to put something here, then I need this, and, yeah, okay, there was a glitch for a second, which disabled me from looking around completely. I have it sometimes, I don't know what it caused it, but normally you have to open the inventory screen to stop it. However, I couldn't, of course, because of the shape and stuff, and for some reason the frame rate is a lot better now, it seems. Or at least it seems to me. I don't know if it actually is on video. I just hope it is. And there's also some more iron here, that's nice. We always need iron, like I always say. I think it's a vein of about 10, so that's a good thing. Oh no, wait, I think... yeah, it's exactly 10. That's good, in my opinion. Well, a last good thing is that I have to leave all the skull behind, because I'm already full. However, I don't feel like it's worth it to, dump anything in my inventory I have right now to form a cobble, except... yeah. The fence would be a good idea, I think, but apart from the fence. So, I'm just going to grab some more stone here. Okay, sometimes your frame rate really goes like double the amount as it was a few seconds ago. It's a bit strange to me, but... well... okay, we now... seeing as it explains the I think we will have to dig some 10 more blocks right now, because planes aren't that much above the actual sea level normally. Yeah, we're already digging. Yeah, this is, I think, the lost dirt, like the dirt from the surface, or... oh no, it isn't, never mind. Maybe this is the dirt from the surface, I don't know. And I wanted to put a torch there, of course, and... whoa, the frame rate is really going smooth now. What the? 100 and... okay, that's really... ridiculous. I'm still recording, right? I have to check for a second. Yeah, I'm still recording. That's really, really strange. I don't have no idea how that's possible, but yeah, it is apparently. It's just ridiculous. I don't know what this will look like on camera, because it's actually recording at a max frame rate of 20, so you won't see it, but it's actually really, really smooth here, and it's ridiculous. Normally I never get to this amount. I don't know what's happening, but well, yeah, I just don't know. Anyways, we're at in a plains biome. Well, most likely in the same as which we entered the actual cave. So yeah, I think we should. So there's already some water over here, actually. Yeah, I'm going to create a, now I think about it. I don't know, it's such a good idea to put it in a something already. Yeah, I don't really know. But, yeah, I'm really hesitating where I should put my nether portal, because I only have one diamond, and this will be, an about permanent location until I have found more diamonds. So, yeah, I don't really see how many times I would have to travel to the Nether and back in this starting part of the series, because in the future I will definitely have to get a diamond pick. I'll think about it, because I will have to create multiple nether portals to keep the speedrun fast. So, as a temporary nether portal for the early part of the preparations, I think this actually does alright, this spot. So yeah, I'm going to try to put it here. First of all, I'm going to make a little area flat here. I'm going to cut this layer of dirt here, so we have a large flat area, at least pretty large. This reminds me a bit of building houses and things like that. When I did that on servers like 6 months ago, I really had to flatten the land a whole lot before I started building. Yeah, it was a bit boring actually, but okay, now we have this, and well, I don't really know for sure how this works. I think, well, the first step for me, to me, I would think that the first step is to put a lava here, and water on top of it. Yeah, now we have two obsidian like this. I'm going to put this back. However, I think we will need, actually, now I think about it, yeah, it's actually not that hard. Now I put lava here, lava there, then I flood it again. Yeah, actually, it's not that hard at all. So, yeah, now we have to go back down, and actually, the sun is already setting. I may have a solution for this. If you look at the amount of iron we have, I feel like we should, never throw away the crafting bench. I should really keep that in mind. Even though it wasn't that big of a mistake in this case, it is in other cases, but yeah. Now I got this back. I'm going to put this over here. Also, in case I might die, I'm going to put up a temporary base here with all my goodies from underground, like coal and iron and gold and rails and string, even flint, because flint is pretty valuable for now for me. Of course, the melon seeds, I haven't actually said it, but for me the melon seeds are really important, as they are about them. You can create completely automatic farms with them, food farms with them now, and it doesn't account for wheat, and well, yeah, and I don't know what about the other ones. However, I'm just going to shear some sheep here. Oh, already dropped 3, that's very good, Mr. Sheep. I'm going to create a bed with it now, of course, so I can sleep and it's again day. Even though it's peaceful, I really like if it's day. I really like it if it's day, and actually it wasn't a good idea to put my my crafting table out of my inventory, because if I pick the other one up, it would mean that I would have to fight all the way back all the way to the NPC village until I could get there more stuff. Anyways, I'm going to put actually most of our stuff here, because we won't need it probably. Yeah, I'll leave it like this. One more. Yeah, I think that would be it. Like this. Yeah. Well, I may make some more of them so I can do this faster, but well, actually I think maybe it takes about a minute to get back down and back up, so I don't really feel like it's really worth it to, well, do special things for it and do like invest more iron just to get this going a bit faster. I mean, the preparations don't have to be fast. And well, so yeah, we're back at this cave, as you can see, and I'm going to collect some more lava here, and we got 2 more, and going back up. I think if I have to estimate something, I would guess it's about 1 minute and 30 seconds to get back up and down. Well, no, if you're demolding to another portal too, if you count that too, it's probably like 2 minutes or so. And well, economy version of the Nether Portal, which I will be using this time, it takes 10 blocks, and well, that means that if for the after we have done these 2 blocks, we still need to do 6, so that means it will take about 6 more minutes if my estimations are a bit correct. However, maybe there aren't, I don't know. So, as you can see, we already have 4 blocks of our obsidian, right? Even though we didn't use any picks, so that's good. I'm going to put cobble right back here. Also, I'm going to take some more cobble because we will need it for the next layer. I'm also going to put a staircase here, of course, so we can get up later on, like this. Oh no, not like that. Like this. So, to put the water back, and we're going back down once again. Well, again, there's not much to say in this part, I think. Unfortunately, but yeah, I mean, it's, as I already said, it's not a let's play, it's a video proof of the fact that I will be doing all these preparations in survival without using any mods. Actually, another question I have is I should always take, well, the effort to remove my single player commands and world edit every game. Because I know some people might be complaining, but I mean, for me, it's just as long as I don't use mods, it's fine. I wouldn't care actually if I looked at a speedrun like this one and the player had mods installed, as long as he didn't use them. But I don't know what about you guys, so yeah. Also, same for something about that, please, so I can know if I should just keep my single player commands every episode, because that would be, well, it's a bit more easy actually. Then, because I have to swap some backup files every time I record these episodes. And yeah, it takes a bit some effort, and I don't really think it's worth the effort sometimes. So yeah, we're back at the top. This is our third layer, and I had to look out there for a second. I nearly put the lava, well, on top of me, I would say. So, yeah. We have our third layer done here. Now we need to do the fourth layer. And after that, the last layer, which is the sixth layer, of course, will be done. And then we can mine all the cobble away. And, well, yeah, we're done then. But, oh, forgot to put my water away. Not that it's that of a big deal. I could still, when I'm at the bottom, I could still just put the water in the water hole I already have there. Also, I might put a tower of dirt or anything here to mark the spot, because I really feel like going back to this place later. Because, well, as you saw in 2 episodes ago, it takes quite a while actually to search caves sometimes, and now I have a big network of how to call it, mine shafts, so don't feel like just giving that up because, well, I have left it. So yeah, we're running. I have to admit, lakes, lava lakes, which have been altered, really look ugly. But yeah, I mean, they're lava lakes. What does it matter? It's not like I will be here that often. I think, well, I'm hesitating whether I should just go to the Nether this episode already, or I should just keep this episode to creating the Nether portal, and the next episode will be entering the Nether portal. Or at least, well, not entering alone, of course, but I mean going to the Nether and doing stuff in the Nether. So yeah, here we're doing our... Yeah, we can still manage to get the water, that's a good thing. Now I will be making the structure for the last layer, which is a bit different, of course. Like this. We'll put lava in here, and then we We'll pour water on it. That's for now. I think it should be. Yep, this is the right size normally. So we're not making any mistakes, that's a good thing. So yeah, we're going down for a last lava. Well, yeah, for a last lava. So, yeah. There's not much to say about it, actually. Well, I actually have no idea how long I've been recording for now. But, well, I would say it's about 10 minutes. And, no, it's a bit short for an episode, but if I go to the Nether, I'll probably do a whole lot of stuff when I'm there. So, I think I will end this episode just when I get the Nether portal completely done. That seems a good idea to me, at least. Probably because I'm already recording quite a lot today. Actually, episode 4, I've recorded it about an hour ago, but yeah, I just, well, video making is sometimes really fun, so then I just decide to do 2 videos in a row, like today. Anyways, here we have two lava things. I'm going to grab our last bucket of water, which we will need, and there we have it, we have our Nether portal frame. Now, we just need to get rid of all the cobble, or, well, I have to admit, this was of course a lot easier if we had a diamond pick, but, well, for now, I just want to get to the Nether quickly. Actually, the first goal in this series is to go to the end and save the Ender Dragon. I know it's a bit of a first, it's a bit of a weird goal to be your first goal, but until we have slain the Ender Dragon, well, we won't do the speedrun. After we've slain the Ender Dragon, we can really start the preparations and create our path for our achievements to be done. Yeah, as you can see, we have our Nether portal here. Luckily, I have some flint from gravel, so I'm also going to take one iron ingot, and then, of course, you'll create a flint and steel, like this. And yeah, we will light our. Not like that. We don't want to set our stuff on fire. And yeah, we have it here, guys. Our Nether portal. Actually, I don't even know what happens if you break it in survival. Okay, apparently you can't break this on survival, T-block, but oh god, even though I lowered my volume, it's really, the noise is this so annoying. Anyways, I'm going to put this flint and steel back in here. I don't feel like it's that useful in the Nether. Well, yeah, just to keep this episode a bit longer, I think I will grab some, well, stuff I will actually need in the Nether. When I think about it, the only thing I need in the Nether is a blaze rod, which actually, well, no, not just a blaze rod, of course we will need more of it, but now I think about it, well, no, actually the next step in this speedrun is creating a blaze XP farm so we can safely get ourselves a blaze rod, and I don't think we're quite ready for that yet. So, well, I feel, well, I just don't really know what I should do then. I have some redstone, but I think it will take a lot more of it. So, yeah, now I think about it, I will have to return to the mines next episode and get more redstone so we can, create a blaze XP farm the episode after that, and well, also we need a bit more cobble, I think. However, for the design, oh no, wait, we also need sticky pistons for the design. I think it's Ito's cone, ice cone design. I'm going to use, So we will need sticky pistons too, and well, so next episode we'll probably go down into our cave again, and we will search for some resources which we will need in the episode after that for our Blaze XP farm. And those resources are slime balls, and well, redstone, as far as I know. Actually, that's the only thing we need. Maybe we'll also get... I have a actually pretty nice design on another server for a well, to let's say save yeah, the safe room of the Blaze XP farm, which uses a bit of glass. So maybe I'll also get a bit of sand from the coast so I can build some nice stuff. Anyways, guys, that's it for this episode. Next time we'll be gathering some resources. I hope you liked this episode. Make sure you leave a rating, so I, and also you give some feedback to me so I can improve my channel. And if you don't mind, also check out my channel and watch some other videos of mine. I'm working on a lot of different series and videos right now. Anyways, that's it, guys. Till next time.